Students, in this video, we would be discussing about two theories of Indian national business, that is product life cycle theory and eclectic theory. First, we will be discussing about product life cycle theory. As we all are aware of, each product has its own life cycle. Like a natural person has, every product has a life cycle, and like a natural person, every product has its own death. So when we talk about a life cycle of a product, it starts from the introduction stage. Once it is done from the introduction stage, it enters the growth stage. When a product is done with the growth stage, it enters into a maturity stage and then into decline stage. Now, when we link various phases of our product with international business, we would be able to identify that with the passes of the life of a product, a chances of international business raises. If a product is in an introduction stage, most of the innovation is done in our developed countries. So if a new product is being developed or created in a developed country, so developed country introduce that product into their own market or into the market of various countries which are similar to their home market. So in an initial phase, when a product is introduced, it is being launched into the various markets which are similar to the home market of the country which has developed that particular product. So since the consumer's style of consumption, income, age, education, background are all similar, so we choose on these parameters and we identify various identical markets, and product has been launched in all those identical markets. And, initially, in the introduction stage, consumers consume the product and they give a feedback about the product. So in the introduction stage, a particular country, either they launch that product in their home country or into that country which has a market condition similar to their home country, so that they get a instant feedback about the consumers, and based on that feedback, requisite updation or modification that is being suggested by various consumers and which a company thinks reasonable and possible to be done, so that all those updation or modification is being incorporated in their product, and the product enters into a growth stage. Into a growth stage, company of home country decides to export it to the other countries also, means to the other countries which are not of identical market, but there are scope of consumption is there. So in a growth stage, what company does is, company of a home country, instead of setting up their manufacturing unit into various countries, they start manufacturing in their home country and start exporting it to the other countries and various markets. So gradually, when the sales are boosted up and they realize a product is going to clear their growth stage and it's going to enter into a maturity stage. So when a product enters into a maturity stage, so what a company does is, a company start shifting the manufacturing to developing countries. Since they have to do production in bulk, and cost of production in developed countries are much more than what whatever it is in developing countries. So when our product enters into a maturity stage and company realizes it's not going to be cost effective if we keep on manufacturing in our home country. So to be cost effective, since the demand is more, product into maturity stage, we need to shift our manufacturing unit from our home country to, which is a developed country, to a developing country. So when a product enters into a maturity stage, so we had an international business and the production unit has been set up into various developing countries. And from those developing countries, a supply to the entire market into various countries has been done. And when a product enters into a decline stage, what company does is company stop manufacturing it in their home country. Since product has entered into decline stage, there is no chances of increase in the demand, or in fact the demand will keep on decreasing gradually. So the developed country, company decides to stop manufacturing and employing their resources into manufacturing of a product which has entered into decline stage. So a company stop manufacturing in their home country, and whatever demand is there in their home country, that has been fulfilled through import from the developing country. Since the manufacturing has been shifted and various developing countries has also start manufacturing their own. Since the product is into maturity stage, there are lots of demand, and there are lots of companies, developing countries, who start manufacturing similar kind of product with similar features. So the developed country, when the product is into a decline stage, stop manufacturing, stop employing their resources into manufacturing of a product which has entered into decline stage in their home market. There can be the case that a product is still in a maturity stage into various developing countries, but into a developed country it has entered into decline stage. So when a product enters into decline stage, a developed country stop manufacturing it and they start importing it from the various developing countries. So that's how, with the passes or various phases of a product life, international business occurs, export shifted to manufacturing unit, and then shifted to manufacturing unit, shifted to importing from the developing countries. That's how something has been done. And all this is happening with the change in the phases of the product life cycle. So when we study our product life, and based on the study of product life, we would be able to identify when to export, when to set up a manufacturing unit into other country, and when to start import and stop manufacturing it. So all these decisions could be taken based on the study of the product life. So that's how international business is happening as per product life. Next theory which we will be discussing is eclectic theory. So eclectic theory is something which helps an organization to decide whether to invest as into other country or keep on manufacturing it their home country. For doing so, we analyze three parameters. So eclectic theory analyzes three parameters, and based on the analysis of three parameters, a decision regarding investment into other country or manufacturing in home country has been taken. So these three parameters are ownership, location, and internalization. So based on that, a company decides whether to invest or manufacturing their home country. So first, we discuss about ownership. So ownership means if a company has any technical know-how, any patent, any trademark, any advanced technology. So if company owns something unique that is not been owned by any other company, So if the answer is yes, in case of answer is yes, so the next step that should be considered is location, from where to manufacture it. And if the answer is no, so you don't have any unique technology, the technology of the product which you are manufacturing is similar to lots of other products, and there is no need to go for international business, you need to remain to your domestic market only. So if you are having a unique product, unique technology, unique manufacturing process, and the answer is yes, so next step which you will be considering is now where to manufacture it, where to employ a technology through which we can manufacture a unique product, and in which particular market we need to supply it. So do we have any kind of location which gives us any kind of strategic benefit? The location which we are considering for manufacturing, if they are giving us some kind of strategic advantage, if the answer is yes, so we will be moving towards the next step. And if the answer is that the location which we have chosen is not giving us any kind of strategic advantage, and the locations which we considered, which we analyzed, don't have any advantage, no benefit to the company, so it's better to stick to your home country only, to manufacture in home country and start export to the other country. So if you don't have any kind of location advantage, you need to manufacture in your home country and you need to export it from your home country only. But if you have a location advantage, a strategy advantage which you are looking in a particular location, if you have that particular advantage, then you need to consider a third step, that is internalization. Internalization is it beneficial to manufacture own or to give license to someone else? So when we're talking about internalization, we consider a transaction cost and the cost of setting up a manufacturing unit in other country. So if the transaction cost is much more than the cost of setting up a manufacturing unit, then you will be going in setting up your own manufacturing unit. But if the cost of transaction is lesser than the cost of setting up a manufacturing unit, so what you would be doing is you will be assigning a license to someone else and you won't be manufacturing your own. So in internalization, in third step, what a company consider is, okay, we have done with ownership, we have unique technology, now we choose a particular location which gives us some strategic advantage. Now when we choose a location, now we need to take a decision whether to set up a manufacturing unit at that particular location or to give a license to some local manufacturer of that particular location so that he can manufacture product using your advanced technology. So when you are going to take this decision of setting up your own unit or giving license to someone else, you consider two costs, that is cost of setting up a manufacturing unit and other cost is transaction cost. If transaction cost is less and setting up of manufacturing unit is more, so you won't be investing in another country and you will be assigning license to the other party and you will be charging royalty. That's how you will be carrying on your international business. But if the cost of setting up a manufacturing unit is much lower than the transaction cost, then you would be going and doing your foreign investment. So you would be investing and you will be setting up your own manufacturing unit in other country. So through eclectic theory, we are able to identify whether we should invest it in other country or we should assign license to someone, local manufacturer of other country, and allow that local manufacturer to use their technology or the process or the patent or anything unique which you have. So through electric theory, we are able to identify and make decision regarding foreign direct investment.